In this screencast, we're going to analyze a splitting point and show why modeling this particular system is a little bit different than other systems we're normally used to looking at. The input to our split point is fully specified. We have a flow rate of 100 kilograms per hour, and we have a specified composition of 30% A and 70% B. If we're just splitting the stream and we're not doing anything to it, then the compositions will not change. The two outputs that we have leaving the split point also have a composition of 30% A and 70% B. But we don't know how we're distributing the 100 kilograms per hour amongst these two streams. So we have two unknown flow rates leaving the splitting point. Now, if we did a degrees of freedom analysis on this system, as we're used to doing it, it would suggest that we can calculate M2 and M3. We know that we can calculate the degrees of freedom by taking the number of unknowns that we have and subtracting the number of independent balances that we can write. Now in this case, we have two unknowns in M2 and M3. And in most scenarios, the number of independent balances that can be written on a system is going to be equal to the number of species that we have. So in this case, we have two species A and B, which suggests that we have 0 degrees of freedom, and we can calculate M2 and M3. But we intuitively know that can't be right. There's an infinite number of ways that 100 kilograms per hour can be split amongst M2 and M3. So why is it that our degrees of freedom analysis is inconsistent with what we intuitively know about our system? To better understand that, we can write the system of material balances and take a look at what they represent. We know that we can write three balances in this case. We have a total balance, and we have a balance on species A and a balance on species B. All three of these balances will have the form of n equals out, so our total balance will be 100 is equal to m2 plus m3. A balance on A would be the mass fraction, which is 0.3 times the total flow rate of 100, and that is equal to 0.3 times m2 plus 0.3 times m3. And similarly, for species B, we have 0.7 times 100, and that is equal to 0.7 times m2 plus 0.7 times m3. If we look closer at the species balances A and B, we can show that these are essentially the same equation. So for example, in balance A, we have a common 0.3 in each term in this material balance. So we can divide by 0.3, and similarly in balance B, we can divide by 0.7. Which shows that we have three versions of the exact same equation. All three of these balances are now showing 100 is equal to M2 plus M3. So there's only one independent balance that we can write in this particular case. If we modify our degrees of freedom analysis, we have two unknowns minus our one independent balance, which leaves us with 1 degree of freedom. So we do have an underspecified system, and we can't calculate M2 or M3 without knowing the other one, which is what makes intuitive sense. So it's important to recognize that when we have a split point, there's only one independent balance that can be written. This is going to be true whether there's two species or 10. There's only one independent balance that can be written around a particular split point. This is particularly important in problems that involve recycle and bypass.